Have you used the file menu? Of course, every day. Have you noticed what is there in it? Probably not. And that's what we will do in this video. Earlier, file menu just used to drop down. But since 2007, it used to occupy the full screen and people got confused. In fact, it's called backstage. Why does it occupy full screen? Because it has so many things to offer. How do you open it? Alt F. And when you open it, you will see other single digit characters like shortcuts. So Alt FC will close. By default, it shows you the home area. The recent files are important, but there is one more thing. If it is a file you open frequently, we forget to pin it. Once you pin it, it goes in a separate area called pinned. And then a very useful area, shared with me. Someone sent you a mail with a link in the mail, but that was 3 months back. No need to search for the mail. Shared with me is the place where it'll show you. How many recent files would you like to see? And that's actually under your control. If you go to File, Advanced, Display, there you can control how many items you want to show in the recent list. Now let's also see the related Open menu. We have different areas, OneDrive, local PC, and what you see in between are Teams. In Teams. So these are Teams channels basically. The right side you see recent files as well as pinned files together. And there's another tab for folders. Very often people miss it. And remember, you can also pin folders. If you like shortcuts, yes, Ctrl O works. But Ctrl O also brings you to this page. I don't want that. I want Ctrl O to directly go to the good old browse dialog. You want that? Absolutely possible. Go to File, Options, and there is a setting for it. The next one is the new tab. Look at the templates. In Word, I'm sure you have checked out resumes already. We have very good proposals and certificates. In Excel, we have nice tutorials with sample data, lot of budget templates, and of course, charts. In PowerPoint, there are some really good infographic templates. Check them out. If your templates are there, they will appear under personal, and organizational templates appear here. The next important section is info. It has some really useful things. One very useful feature is mark as final. Probably you never thought about it, but you have created a file. It is shared with people. Everyone knows it is finalized, but someone opens it and by mistake some change happens. We want to prevent inadvertent changes, then mark it as final. Another one is check for issues, and under that, inspect document. So many people have suffered because some confidential information, some stray comment, some track change went to customer and that created a disaster. So inadvertent leakage of information can be prevented. Run the inspector and look at how many different things it can check. And in one click, it can remove all of them. Imagine removing all notes in one click. Very useful. I have a separate video for that. Accessibility is important. There are many people in the world who have some challenges. Could be auditory, visual, and so on. And it is our responsibility to make sure everyone can read the content you create. That's the reason you created it, isn't it? It's in your interest also. So there are so many different mistakes which we do, which we don't realize. For example, this is yellow background and white text. It's difficult to read. Or we have a picture, but we have not described what the picture is. These are called accessibility problems. And Microsoft has a very, very sophisticated system for it. It is capable of detecting all kinds of problems. And it'll tell you the corrective measures also. If possible, it'll do the automatic action as well. So checking accessibility before you send a document is really important. In PowerPoint, there are two great features in Info tab. Very often we put videos and the file size grows. If you have even one video in the PowerPoint, it will show you the compress media button. It gives you three options. You choose the resolution you want, and then it can significantly reduce the file size. Another common problem with videos is you put a video on a Mac and then you send the PPT someone is trying to run it on a Windows PC and it doesn't run because the codec is missing. PowerPoint actually understands that. And then in info tab, it will show you optimize compatibility button. Always look for it, and if you find it, click on it. It doesn't ask you any complicated questions. It's just going to solve the problem by re-rendering the video into something where it will always run on Windows. And both compress as well as optimize will work in one click, whether you have one video or 200 videos in the PPT. With Outlook, we have some interesting options. The mailbox has limited size, so it shows you how much space is available. You can not only have Microsoft Exchange configured in Outlook, you can have different mail accounts, so you can change account settings from here. And finally, you have out of office, which is called automatic replies. We also have a nice import export option for Outlook. Now let's talk about save and save as. We store it either on OneDrive, or you also see a list of teams, and that's important. If a file is relevant for a project, do not put it on OneDrive, put it directly in the relevant team. Often we open a file and we save as because we want to make changes. So the important thing to remember is open the file, save as, and then make changes. Because of autosave, if you open the file, make changes, and then save as, the changes also go in the original file, and that confuses us. Next is print, which is fairly routine, and some options may change depending on whether it is PowerPoint or Word or Excel. The share is a button which will open the universal share dialog. It's not really part of the file menu, but it's an entry point for sharing. Export means make a copy in a completely different format. So all of them will support export as PDF. They also have different file types. Depending on the app, you may want to save it as images or CSV or TXT and so on. But Word has some special options, like it can create a web page from a Word document using Sway. Under PowerPoint, you can even create an animated GIF or convert it to a video and even upload the video directly on stream. There is one feature on browser versions which is embed the file in a website. Next, let's look at the account tab. If you're not sure which type of office you have, go to the account tab and look at what is written there. If you see Microsoft 365 for Enterprise, that means it's the cloud connected version. If you see a year number like 2016, 19, 21, that means it is a desktop only version. Another thing to add there is many of us work on multiple organizations, so you can have multiple OneDrive accounts added. You can also add personal accounts, and non-OneDrive cloud storage can also be added. Options is a very big topic. I'm not going to cover it here, but the concept is if you want to change the way an app behaves, whether it is Word or Excel or PowerPoint, then the setting will be under options. I have top 10 settings videos for each app separately. So that is the file menu. Did you find something useful? Then give me a like, share it with as many people as you can, and do let me know, should I cover one menu at a time like this? Is it useful? I create one video every day as far as possible, so do subscribe, click on the bell icon, and see you next time. Thank you.